Good morning, boys and girls. So we did the an I Do. Remember where Miss Terry modeled for you what compare and contrast look like? Remember how things are the same and how things are different? We did that last week. So we're looking at our objective. I will be able to compare and contrast different characters or events. And how are two characters, we're worried about two characters in a story right now. How are they the same and how are they different? So today we're going to do it for a little bit as a group, but then I'm letting you take over. You're going to go back to your interactive journals and you're going to show me that you know how to do that. Nod your head if you understand that so far. Yeah, okay. I know you're supposed to. All right. Can anybody remember what is a good tool that we use to show things that are different about characters in a story and things that are the same? Can anybody think in your brain, what is this thing called? What is that called? Alana?
Venn diagram.
You are a genius. Kiss your brain. A Venn diagram. Very good. And what do I put? This is just one. Remember we did, what was it? The Three Little Pigs? That was one of our examples. What do we put here? Do we put things that are the same or things that are different over on these sides? Sean?
Different.
Things that are different. Very good. So like pig one, he built his house out of hay, whereas we said pig three, that was different. He built his house out of Anthony?
Bricks.
Very good. What, for example, what did we put in between that they both had where the circles touched? What did we put in between? For pig one and pig three, we were like, wow, they both have that in common. So we put it in the middle. What? Give me an example. Ogie Okafer?
You put it in the middle. The front is the same.
Right. It's something the same. Give me an example of pig one, pig three. What did they both have in common? What did they both have that was the same?
They both have a common because they both are pigs and they both are pink and they both look like pigs.
Ooh, angry birds. Exactly. They're both pigs. They're both pink. That's right. And I love that you said it like as in a full sentence. They both have in common that they're both pink. They're both pigs. Very good. Let's see. So we used our example of Three Little Pigs. We also looked at Goldilocks and the Three Bears, and we did that as well, remember? Let's see. So today, what you're going to do is more of a where you go out and you do that and you show me. So in your interactive journals for page 2 on here, it looks a little different than our other diagram. It's like the two circles, just like this, but you're going to have to do this. Let me make sure I have all eyes. Okay, good. Wait, I'm missing eyes. Okay, good. You're going to have to flip your reading journal like that because I wanted to give you a lot of room, okay? So what you're going to do is some of you will have stories like this where they don't really, they have pictures for the characters. They have pictures, but they don't have words. And you get to pick out any two characters within that story and write about their similarities and their differences. Some of you may have some words, and I know, because that would be too easy peasy lemon squeezy. So what we did, some of you may have ones with words in it, and you can sound that out. I know you can. So you can read the story, and that'll help you also see similarities and differences. Some of you will also be with Miss Terry, and we'll be reviewing some of the books that we've read, and we'll be practicing in our reading journals what they have in common and how they're different. Okay? Are there any questions? Think about it. Sakani Tudor.
How do you get to be a smarter?
How do you get your accountability? I know that's what you're saying because you always. Your accountability is. We'll go look over here. That's a great question. Your accountability for this one is voice level 1, which is a whisper. Okay? So you're allowed to whisper. If you need help, look around the room because we'll have our chart up. Quietly ask your elbow nearer if there's something you really don't understand. Hey, friend, can you help me? I don't understand this. and they will be able to help you, all right? And then if you really need help, you can raise your hand and Miss Terry will come over if I don't have my conferencing crown on, okay? Activity, we're going to do our readers, we're going to do our they, well, you do. Movement, not unless you can get out of your seat, only if you need to use the restroom, if it's an absolute emergency, okay? That's how you get your accountability, all right? And maybe I'll have a few people share. Whoever has the best work, we can do some sharing, all right? Any more questions? All right, let's go do it. Okay, follow my fingers. You're gonna go back to your tables and Miss Terry will pass out the book for you, okay? Need all eyes, I'm missing a, see a head. Okay, now I see it. Woo, so quiet. All right, flip through. There's three stories you can choose from. So flip through and find the one you want to use. Some of you will have ones with words in them, and some of them you will have just the pictures. All right, pick a good one. Pick a good one. All right, go ahead. Okay, I will have Autumn bring your book and your interactive journal to my desk, please. Anthony, bring your interactive journal and book to my desk. Ogie, bring your journal and your book to my desk. Alana, bring your interactive journal book to my desk, please. May I have your attention, please? Hands up, hands down. Just a reminder, for a few minutes, I'm gonna have my conferencing crown on. Can someone tell me what that means? Raise their hand and tell me what that means. Sakani?
That means, don't.
What happens? Yes, just be patient. When it comes off, then you can raise your hand and ask me. Thank you. All right, so what we're gonna do is I want you, let's see, everyone, look through your book and I want you to pick a story. Let's pick a story. You're gonna choose Ben? Okay.
Why do you like the title?
Oh, you're right, that's a great question. We could put it, we're kind of out of room, huh? We could put it right here, Ben, B-E-N.
And I don't think we can put any picture of the characters there.
That's why I had a really, really big circle, so we can put pictures of the characters. Why don't we start with one that we all have in common? Let's close these books. Let's just review really quickly. Let's review. How about The Tale of the Three Little Pigs? Autumn, you want to pick up two pigs to compare? Give me one character to compare. Hold on 1 second, I'll call on you. Okay. Which one is that? Do you know? Is that pig one, pig two, pig three?
Pig one.
That's pig one? All right, so we can do that. So let's put pig one. All right, let's flip it. We'll put pig one right in here. Puh. Ig. One. Neat and sweet, neat and sweet. Flip it this way, Anthony. A little confusing. We're gonna flip them this way today. Pig one will go here, and then we'll figure out what's going to go here. So can you write pig one right there? Puh. Pig. Your best handwriting. You're a genius. Very good. All right, let's get ready. I'll let you pick the second character.
I have words in my book.
Let's flip it this way. Very good. So let's write pig one right here. We'll write our first character right there. Pig one. Okay, Alana, what do you want for the second character? Where do we want to, what do we want to compare? Which character?
The three little pigs.
The third little pig? Okay. So pig three. So we'll write pig again, just like the first one, and then we'll put the number three. I love how hard Dominic is working right now. He must want his accountability treat and maybe to share.
Guess what? He has the same thing.
Oh, yeah, he does, doesn't he? Mm-hmm. Got it?
Puh. E. Where's puh? E. G. E. I. G.
And what's the last sound? G. G. G.
G.
And we're going to do pig three, so we're going to put a three right there. Okay, so tell me one thing. What do they have in common? What is pig one and pig three? There it is. What is pig one and pig three? What do they have in common? What do they have that are the same? They're the same.
They're both the same because they both have houses.
They both built houses. Very good.
And they're both pigs.
They're both pigs.
And pink.
Very good. Where do we put that, Ogie? Can you show me on our graphic organizer, on our Venn diagram, where do we put that?
Here.
Right in the middle. All right, you ready? We're going to write, they're both pink, we figured out. So pink, let's write that where it belongs. They both have that in common. Anthony, where do you put something that's in common? You put it over here, here, or here? Very good. All right, so we're going to write pink. Where, Autumn? Where do we put something that's in common? All right, pink. So we're going to say they both have that. All right, let's write it. Pink, we know that. Puh, ink. Where can we look if we don't know how to write that? Of course, yes. Or you could use the word wall. We'll write up over there. Now, let me try something when you're done. Okay, we know that, let's look at pig three right here. Here's pig three. She made her house out of bricks. That's different from pig one. So where would I put that for pig three, that she made her house out of bricks? If that's different, where do I put it, Anthony? Wow, okay, you are correct. Made her house out of bricks. So we could say house made out of bricks. Or you could draw some bricks. If you're a super genius, try and sound it out. So I'm gonna draw some bricks. Keep it up, about five more minutes. Mm-hmm. It does have a spine. What about, let me see, okay. What about pig one? Let me go to pig one. Pig one, oh, why?
It has a white coat.
Something that is the same. Pig one and pig two. Can you explain what you're writing? Which two characters are you comparing? Start there. Which two characters are you comparing? The pig and the, what is that?
Cat.
Cat? Okay. So which side is this?
The cat.
Cat. Oh, I see cat. And that's pig. All right. So how are they different? What did you write here?
Cat's got a little bit wet.
Cat got a little bit wet. How about pig?
Pig got a lot wetter.
Oh, she got a lot more wet? Oh, so that's different. So you put that there. What did you say so far that they have in common, that cat and pig have in common?
They both have a pink shirt.
They both have a pink shirt. Oh, nice. I like that. Very good. Keep it up. See what else they have. What are you writing for yours so far? Which two, you have to pick out two characters. I don't see that you've done that yet, so let's see. Which two characters do you want to compare? Baby Bear's family. Which two characters? You can do Mama, you could do Papa, one of the babies. Pick one. How about we do, I'll help you out. We'll do Baby Bear and let's do Mama Bear. Can you tell me something that they have in common, Baby Bear and Baby Bear and Mama Bear? What do they both have in common?
They're both brown.
They're both brown? Okay, there's a starting point. So where would you put that, right here? Okay, so let's do that. They're both brown. If I don't know the word brown, where can I look? Where would color words be?
Here, in there.
And the word will, okay. All right, so let's start there, brown. You showed me it, now write it. You just started. Are you doing this? Get set, play. Okay. How are you doing here? Gotta flip it. Remember. Which two characters are you comparing? You guys love this story. Oh, you're doing the. Oh, that's different. Okay, it's different from Aubrey. So you're doing elephant. You're comparing elephant and pig. Okay. What do they have? Tell me something that's different. What does elephant have about elephant that pig doesn't have? What's different?
A trunk.
A trunk? Ooh, that's a fancy word. Yes, very good. A trunk. So where would you put that? Where's elephant side? Where's pig side? Oh, I see elephant. So there's elephant. And then that must be pig side. Okay. What do they both have in common? I see you haven't put anything, so what do they have in common?
People.
You see anything in common? I don't see anything yet. Let's keep flipping and looking. Oh, goodness gracious. Oh, look at that, look. Looks like she might have some, she might have gotten wet too as well.
Both wet.
They're both wet. So where do we put that? They have that in common. Where does it go? All right. I'll let you get to it. Yes, sir. Okay. Where's your pencil at? We want to use our pencil first. I need help writing the word. Okay. Which word are you trying to write and where?
They are the same as different.
They are the same as different. Where you're trying to write right here, they are the same because why?
They're brown.
Which two characters are you trying to compare? You're on the right track. This boy and which boy? These two? Okay, they're the same because why?
Because.
We know they're both at school. They're both what? They're both playing at school. Okay, they're both playing using what?
Chalk.
Okay, so where would we put that if we said that about these two characters? If they're the same, where do we put that? Try these two. If we were saying, comparing these two, and we said they're both the same because they're playing with chalk, would we put it right here? In the middle? Okay. So let's, we could put that, playing with chalk. Do you know how to write that? Use your pencil. Because if you goof, you can erase it with a pencil. Which story are you doing? Okay, about 2 more minutes and we're gonna do our little author share chair. We'll have 3 kids share. We can make it. All right, so what are you comparing? Which 2 characters are you comparing? Those 2? Okay, what do they both have in common? She's making something. And he's making something. So they are both making. So where would you put that? Oh, in the middle. Okay. Yes, ma'am? You can write words, yes, or if you're having trouble with the word, you can also write pictures.
They both have 8 tails. They both have long arms.
They both have long arms. Who are you comparing, Ben and Ben?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
Those are their 2 names.
What does it say here? What has Ben, how is Ben different than Ben?
Because Ben's pet is up in the tree.
Oh.
And he doesn't.
Who is he?
Ben doesn't have one.
Oh, I see. Okay. This is, Ben is a dog, Ben has a white cat. Is that what it said in the story?
No, that doesn't say cat. That says coat.
Oh, I'm sorry, coat. Coat. I see it now, okay.
Coat.
Gotcha, all right. Very good.
I'm gonna say short.
Oh, short arms, not long arms. That's a problem, they both do. I hope they have a solution. Do they have a solution at the end? I know you're all about figuring that.
This is the last page.
Oh. Okay. So it looks like they have some sort of solution. All right. How are we doing over here?
What's it at?
That's a panda bear, but you have to figure out his name.
His name's Ben.
Is it Ben?
It's Ben.
Ben.
Ben is B.
All right. May I have your attention, please? Hands up. Hands down. All right. Looking good so far. I'm going to have real quickly, I'll have Righteous, Tyler R., and Aliana bring their interactive journals to the carpet to share, compare, and contrast, okay? The rest of you, go ahead and close your interactive journals. Put them away in your seat sacks. But Righteous, Tyler R., Aliana, bring it down for a share chair. So beautiful. Thought it was because it was close to Christmas break you had forgotten, but I was so wrong. He'll get it. Oh, he'll get it. You let him get it. All right, he wants to be my first. Let me see. I will have Righteous Belton come on up. You want me to hold it for you? You hold it, and then, or I'll hold it, you share.
This is the bear's name. This is
Ben and Ben. Okay, go ahead. I'll get to the story.
Ben's pet is up in the tree.
Well, so who's Ben? Is this Ben? I'm assuming he has a shirt that says Ben. This is Ben. Okay. If this is Ben, Dominic, can you hold this for me so I can just hold that up for the class so they can see what we're talking about? Stand up and hold it, please. Thank you, sir. Hold it to the class. Okay, so if this is Ben, what does Ben have that Ben doesn't have? Like, what's different about Ben from Ben?
Ben doesn't have a pet like Ben.
Ben does not have a pet like Ben. Oh, wow. Okay. What did you put in the middle that they have in common? What's the same about Ben and Ben? Both have a tail?
They both have a tail.
How about that? Let me see. Can you show the class? They both do have a tail. If you can't find anything, at least look at what they look like. Maybe there's something. What else?
They both have short arms.
Short arms. Look at their little... Does that become a problem in the story? They both have little tiny short arms?
Mm-mm. That's not a problem in the story.
They both... But they can't reach something? Is that it?
Mm-hmm.
They both have short arms. All right. What does Ben have? Ben is a dog.
Ben is a dog. Ben has a white coat.
Okay, yeah, that's definitely different. Ben is a dog.
A white coat.
And what is Ben? Is Ben a dog too?
Mm-mm.
He's a what?
I said panda.
Yeah, he's a panda bear. Those are different, so we put them on different sides of the circles. Very good. All right, let's do our mirror cheer for Miss Righteous. Here we go. Ready?
I want it seminal cheer.
Seminal cheer. All right, we can do this in the wheelchair.
Oh.
Very good. You may go put that up. Next, I'll have Aliana McDuffie come on up and share. Thank you, Rick. Thank you, sir. I brought your buck up. Which story did you do? Which one?
Pig.
Pig can get wet. Ooh, good. It's a different one. All right, let's see if she did it. Is it this one? Oh, pig can get wet. It's the last story. All right. Pig can get wet. All right, on your bottoms. All right, Paige, where's our Venn diagram? Aha, there it is. All right, you hold that up. Dominic, can I borrow you again? Can you be my little model, my little book model? You're so good at that. Thank you. All right, ready? Tell us something that was the same in Pig Can Get Wet. What was the same? Let's start. Which two characters did you compare and contrast? Which two? Who's
Pig.
That? Pig. And
Elephant.
I see that you wrote elephant. Go ahead and let's... All right, pig and elephant. What did you say about pig?
Pig.
What did you say about elephant?
She has a
trunk, I think is what you told me. She has a trunk. Does pig have a trunk? No. So where did you put it? Very good. You put it on the side of elephant. What did they both have in common? Let's do one thing they both had in common. What did pig and elephant have in common?
They
both have no hair. Oh, in the back? You say pig had hair.
She's really wearing a...
Oh, I didn't even notice that. They're both actually bald. Pig and elephant, they don't have any hair on their head. Very good. Let's do a quick mirror cheer.
Ooh, looking good.
Thank you, Missy. Last but not least, Tyler R. Which story did you do, Tyler? Which one? The boat. Oh, that's a different one. Okay. All right, you start. You show us, and I'll get the boat one. Let me get the boat. what is it called? Race Day? Race Day? Which two characters? My Red Boat? Which two characters did you compare? I don't know. Who is that?
The kid and the dad.
The kid and the dad. Very good. Okay, let's see. What do they have in common? What's two things that the kid and the dad have that are the same?
A boat.
They both have a boat. They're both working on a boat. Very good. Did you write that? Where did you write that at? What does that say? They are both people. They are both people. They both have arms. Okay. And they both have a boat. I see it right there. Very good. What do they have that's different? I see you drew a picture. What do they have that's different?
Close.
I love how quiet David is. I can tell he's paying attention. His eyes are right on us. Oh.
Close.
Yeah, he has, oh, the clothes are different. He has like a red shirt on. What's different about Dad? What'd you put about Dad? Yeah, this one didn't tell us as much, so you did a good job. He had a blue, that's different. Exactly. Oh, he had like a purple shirt on. Very good. Kiss your brain. Impressive. Do I want to give you a hallelujah? I do. I don't want this thing to move. All right, you're getting a hallelujah for that one. That's the best work you have ever done. I am so proud of you for staying on task. What's the secret? All right, come up here. Put this up. I hope I don't. All right, you ready? Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Very good. I'm so proud of you. Go ahead and go put this up. Oop, my think aloud's on. There you go. Okay, so thumbs up. Let's go. Let's close it. I will be able to compare and contrast different characters in events. Do you think you can compare and contrast different characters, different events? Thumbs up if you say yes. Thumbs down if you're like, I still need help. Aubrey? Okay. How are two characters the same or different? You think you know how you can tell? I know if these two are the same or these two characters are different, and I know where to put it. You think you can do that? Thumbs up if you say yes. Thumbs down if you're like, I still need help on that. I don't know where to put if something's the same or something's different. Okay. All right. I think you did a great job. I want everybody to kiss your brain. Pat on the back.